really hope YouTube works for me, because now I feel like I'm a YouTube ambassador. YouTube. Hello, welcome back to Onifole TV. I'm Chinwe, still wilding and thriving. I know you've not heard it before, but it's just something I came up with this week. And I figured I'm going to make it my motto because I'm a wild thing and I stay thriving. Thank you so much if this is your first time on my channel. And if you enjoyed this video, do like and subscribe so that you can join the wilding and thriving community. But if this is not your first time on my channel, thank you so much for always stopping by. And if you've not joined the wilding and thriving community, all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and turn your notifications so that you don't miss any of my uploads. In this video, I'm going to be discussing YouTube fetish. This is going to be a very interesting video because I've brought three friends along. They are this nail polish remover, this cutting wool, and this a nail polish. So this is, I got from the market for like 100 naira. They told me 250 won. I priced it down. I haggled. Then this one is 50 naira. I got it from like a regular supermarket. And then this one is a nail polish I got so many years ago from Primark. It was like £1.50 or even less. So yeah, I'm going to be painting my nails while I discuss YouTube fetish, because why not? The person that introduced me to YouTube is one of my best friends in the world. And she's so into YouTube that she can watch YouTube from morning to night. And then I didn't understand it. I'll be like, why would you want to watch people live their life? Do you understand? Like, because I felt like that was what YouTube was. It didn't make sense to me. But now, I know that the reason why she watches so much was getting to that. Let me not give out everything now. So, yeah. She was so into YouTube. And then, like, it didn't make sense to me then. Because even when I tried to go on YouTube, the only videos I managed to watch were her own. Because as I then, she had, like, a makeup channel on YouTube where she was, like, posting her videos. So, I'm a very loyal friend. When she posts video, I'll just go there, watch her own. After watching, I'll close YouTube and go back. But this thing continued, though. Continued. My friend was still watching YouTube. She was always telling me things happening on YouTube, like people doing different things on YouTube, like weird stuff. And I'll be like, are you serious? And you're watching them. Who has that kind of time? I couldn't relate. So this thing continued, though, until last 2 years when I now started making my own YouTube videos. And mind you, what I used to do on YouTube then was just watch music videos or my friends' videos. So I decided to start making YouTube videos because I felt like that was like the easiest way to get my message across and like make a point. If you don't understand this aspect of my life, you can go and watch one of my previous videos where I talked about the struggles of being a YouTuber. Yeah, I discussed that in detail there. Even when I started making my videos, I would still just upload my video and like go my own way. Like, I didn't really care about the YouTube community. I didn't even know there was a YouTube community, do you understand? But let me just go straight to the point. I'm now into the YouTube community. And it's not just one community they have on YouTube, but there are several of them. There are so many things happening on YouTube. It still amazes me how many views these people get on YouTube. Like, people that, what they do on YouTube, like, it's something you have to go and see for yourself. I'm going to tell you some of them, but it's just something you have to go and see for yourself. Like, maybe I didn't search enough, but there's probably someone on YouTube that all she does is just paint her nails and people watch her. Internals. I don't know if I'm doing it wrong, but maybe I should just come closer. I have really fine nails, right? Thank you. That's why I don't paint my nails. I can't remember last time I painted my nails, but just for this video, I was like, what can I even do? Like, what weird stuff can I do while I talk about this topic on YouTube? So I figured I might as well paint my nails and carry for like 2 days. Because the reason why I don't paint my nails is because they're always cheap. Even when I use the gel polish, it's as if like everything runs down and then there's this annoying space here. But just for you guys, I'm going to be painting my nails. And for some reason, I have several nail polishes because I like to do my nails myself. My toenails have so many colors. So if this is a thing, I'll probably paint my nails every time. So if this is your first time on my channel, you're wondering, this must be a very weird girl. This is my last time on her channel. Maybe I won't do it here, but I diverge a lot. Going back to my YouTube. So there are so many things happening on YouTube, guys. There are people that all they do on YouTube is eat. When I say eat, I mean like bring out food, pour it inside plate. Some don't even pour inside plate, they eat straight from the pack and then start eating. Like all they do on YouTube is eat. You get? And there are millions of people that watch them. Then there are people that what they do on YouTube is get microphone and then making crunchy sounds and crispy sounds into the microphone. Like they call it ASMR. They'll just get like microphone and I don't have a microphone, I would have showed you guys. Like, it's really relaxing. The time I listen to it, I was like, yeah. That one I've not gotten really into it because
for some reason, I'm still like, oh, really? And then there are people, the ones you guys already know, what they come to YouTube for is makeup. They watch people make up. And the funny thing is that most people, they think that they're coming to YouTube to learn something. But at the end of the day, you just end up watching people. You might not even necessarily learn what they are doing, but there's just something entertaining about watching someone do something, like living vicariously through someone else. Does that make any sense? So I think that's what YouTube is about. And thinking about it, it's making more sense to me because I figured, I mean, that's why people watch movies. Just that movies, we know that they are scripted, but YouTube is more spontaneous and like live, do you get? But movies are scripted, and that's why Hollywood and Nollywood and all the woods around the world keep making money, because there are people that just derive joy in watching other people or living their life through other people. So my dear, there are things happening on YouTube. There are weird people on YouTube. There was a time I searched how to do magic, and I found several pages, several channels on YouTube that can teach you how to do magic. White magic or black magic or... They're always out of Nigeria, sure. Even when they are Nigerian, they were not raised here. Like, they have like the Western exposure and stuff. Why is it that we don't have like channels like that? Like, people from Nigeria that grew up in Nigeria that actually start weird channels like that. I call it weird because it's not the norm in our area. Like, just doing, we believe so much in suffer work, not even hard work. We believe so much in suffer work in Nigeria that there are so many opportunities out there to the Westerners that are available to us as well, but we can't even see because, no, that's too easy. You understand? Like, how can I come and be eating and then I'll have millions of people viewing me, and after it, someone will pay me millions of dollars just to assess those people that watch me eat. Yeah, it has to do with orientation, sure. I don't know if this scene is as satisfying as I want it to be to you guys, because my hands are shaking. Probably if it becomes a thing, I'm sure I'm going to get better at painting my nails, because this is the first time I'm painting my nails in a very, very long time, like years. So pardon me if my hand is shaking. I guess the reason why we don't have Nigerians that eat on YouTube and have millions of people, because nobody will even believe that kind of channel will go far. But these Indocha people, people in the abroad, they believe in all sorts of things. They believe in themselves so much that they feel like they can just come and do anything and come and be watching them. They actually do. Like, I have a lot of channels that I follow that all they do is just, hi guys, so today I'm going to go and grab lunch with my mom, and then I'll come out, I think I have a nail appointment, then I'll go see my therapist for like an hour or 30 minutes. That is all they do. Like, it's not scripted. They just wake up, live their life for the day, and then upload it for people to watch. You know, that's a very good opportunity. If you're watching this video and it's blowing your mind, shoot, because I entered YouTube thinking, oh, I'm going to go and teach people something, I'm going to go and like lecture, do you understand? Because, oh, they want to know what I know, I'm going to tell them what I know. But I realized the truth is that most people don't even go on YouTube to learn. They might think they are going there to learn something, but at the end of the day, you just stay for the entertainment. I'm 100% sure that at least 70% of people subscribe to me might not necessarily be watching me because, oh, like I'm making the highest sense. Maybe that could be a reason, but it's mostly because for some reason, maybe the way my mouth opens and closes and the way my hands go around, that might really be the reason why some people are watching. Because I think about it, I know I say a lot of meaningful things. Maybe it's just the entertainment aspect too, and just doing you. Do you understand? But yeah, it was just something I was thinking about. I felt like it was going to just be fun to do. Do you understand? I mean, one thing I love about YouTube is that nobody is going to call me and tell me, see, Chimu, we've had enough of you. Don't ever upload your video. But then, no, there's nothing like that. People that invented YouTube, they're probably cashing out at home and they want more content. They just want content, basically. They just want content that will bring traffic to their site. So, if you're out there and you're thinking, what can I do in my life? Just open your laptop or your phone and start recording yourself. Doing anything. Don't go and do porn and now say, oh, it's when they collect TV you got it from. Well, if you do porn, I'm sure there are people that watch it and there are sites that will collect that from you. But for YouTube, you just mostly freestyle. I still do my trainings. If you want to attend any of my trainings or my business stuff, call your girl or send me an email and I'll schedule you for one of our trainings. My number one for YouTube. Sorry, I'm talking Google girl. But if it's for YouTube, I'm just going to keep it very freestyle, honestly. Because what I've seen with my eyes, what I've smelled with my nose,
Yeah, sometimes I feel like I can perceive the food that people are eating online. They call it mukbang. Mukbang. It sounds bad, but it's really not bad. It's just mukbang. Those that just eat online. I think I'm going to do like a series of me trying out different fetish. I call it fetish because, I mean, it's weird for you to be enjoying that kind of thing. And things you enjoy that are weird, I call it fetish. So I think I'm going to do like a series of me doing weird stuff. Not really weird stuff, but just popular tags on YouTube. Maybe making up. No, making up. I might just make you forget the right way to make up if I show you how I make up. So maybe we'll leave makeup out of it. But just things that are on the extreme that are not so popular. Because guys, there are opportunities. And I've been telling my friends and everybody around, I've been encouraging everybody, just start recording your phone and uploading on YouTube. Because I have a very strong feeling that YouTube is going to explode in Africa this year, and it's just about plugging yourself in so that when it happens, you'll be there to benefit from it. You understand? See, you don't need to make sense to anybody. Just let it be something you enjoy. Let it be something you are comfortable with. Show yourself, because there are people showing themselves. Hey, there are people showing themselves. There's this one I'm following. I'm a very loyal subscriber and stuff like that. Her name is Nicolette Gray. They call her Beverly Hills Brat. She's very funny. I mean, that's why I'm surprised, and I'm always watching her video, like I'm catching up on Game of Thrones. Like, she does a lot of challenges. That's what's entertaining about it. Maybe she'll do something like spending a day in my closet, 24 hours in my closet, 24 hours in a limousine, 24 hours in a supermarket, stuff like that. I know you don't have a limousine to sleep in and spend 24 hours in, or you don't have a closet. Like, all you have is a drawer. But there are just things. There are just things that you can engage in that would relax someone else when they watch you. You understand? You necessarily don't have to make sense. YouTube is a very, very big opportunity. The highest paid people on YouTube are not the makeup people. No, the makeup people are making money quite alright. They are the people we know. They are the people that most Nigerians aspire to. That's why you have 1 billion people making up on YouTube from Nigeria, because they've seen that makeup pays because of Chidimmu. There are so many other things that pay. Like, the highest earners on YouTube are people that prank, people that just make fun of themselves, toy people, people that play games. And hey, there are people that actually play games and then record their screen and upload on YouTube. Those people, they have millions of views, because not everybody can afford a PS2. I don't even know the logic behind it. I just know that the highest earners on YouTube are not the people you think they are. They are the jokers, they are the jonesers, and they are the chillers. There's this family I started following last year. They call themselves the Ace Family. I'm part of them. Hey, Ace Family. They are in like 15 million subscribers now. When I followed these people, September last year, they were at 6 million subscribers. And then I subscribed to them. And it was as if that my subscribing doubled their subscription to 12 million. And now they're 15 million. I don't know how it happens, though. But guys, we need to start supporting each other. Internet is now cheap in Nigeria, and YouTube can be a career. All these international investors, all these international companies, they are looking for ways to enter Nigeria. All they are looking for is someone that have the markets they want to talk to. And that's what YouTube provides to you. If you start making YouTube channels and you can garner for yourself like enough subscribers that when a company approaches you, you hold your mouth straight when you're saying thousands of dollars. Do you understand? But we just have to support each other. We just have to open view, even if you don't want to watch through, just view, because that way your algorithm increases and your exposure increases on YouTube, and other people can find your videos, and we can just support each other by just, when someone does something, just view it, even if it's you and that and insult the person, just do, because I think that's what these abroad people do. Our internet is actually cheaper than their own, because I've stayed in the abroad and I know how expensive the internet is compared to the internet I use in Nigeria. If we can just believe more in ourselves and in the chilling life that God has prepared for us, just do something. See Funny To Help and all those funny people on Instagram. Now, comedy is now like a career that you can comfortably tell your parents that, oh, I want to be a comedian when I grow. Before, it wasn't like that. So a grown-ass man, medical graduate, can open their mouth and tell their parents, oh, I want to be a comedian. Why? Because they've seen someone that did comedy and it worked for them. So guys, I'm telling you, I know I'm not still cashing out on YouTube, though, but I know I paid it very close. So I'm just telling you, you can start recording yourself. Don't wait till you get sharp camera. Just upload. And just, because I really want our content, like African content, Nigerian content, to be at the same level with these Westerners' content. For example, someone from America could upload a video and it could be suggested to me on YouTube. But I don't think I can make a video now and they'll suggest my video to someone in the abroad. Do you understand? So I feel like it depends on our engagement. From the location I mean, it depends on the engagement. Do you understand? Like, that collaborative effort. So guys, just engage so that we can boost our content and to increase our chances of getting to the level that all these people are. Because I think that Chidinma Umi should have at least 1 million subscribers by now. If she was in the abroad, she would have gotten like 1 million subscribers. She's doing so well though. But I think that at just group efforts, Nigerians could just increase our engagement on YouTube. And then our videos, our content, whoever it is, can be suggested to people in Australia, in the UK, in the America, in just in the abroad in general, so that this money can start rolling in. Because you know, you guys really know, we can't depend on the money in this country, because I think the money in this country have already been shared. They divided everything and they did not include you. So you have to start thinking of where to go and get it from. If you are waiting for your next break, while you wait, just record yourself talking. Record yourself doing something fun, because when you upload it on YouTube, there's going to be someone somewhere that will watch that video and just be entertained. And what everybody wants in this life is just to be happy. And they are looking for that happiness everywhere. They don't even mind trolling online to get satisfaction. They don't mind watching someone twerk online to get satisfaction. They don't mind watching someone like me. There's this channel I've been addicted to like for 2 weeks now. What they do is DIY. They make over homes. I've watched it so much, like someone that is preparing for an interior design class. It's all for the entertainment. And in addition to the entertainment, you'll be inspired. You'll see what's out there. You actually know what you want. Because sometimes it's as if, I've gotten to that point where, what else? What else can I possibly want again from this life? Because even all the ones that I want, I'm not going to be. But when you see people from different parts of the world live their life and express themselves, it gives you more options to the things you might want for your own life. So guys, just go out there. First of all, it's going to increase our chances of being suggested to people in the abroad, that's outside Nigeria. It has the potential to make you a millionaire. I'm not joking, because all these brands, when they are talking about marketing and presenting their product or their services, they mean business and they are willing to pay you for that business. So you get the money. For those of you that want fame, you're gonna be known and you have fun doing what you're doing. You understand? Your content will be from your life. How did it come out? So these are my nails after the act. I actually did well. Since I'm done painting my nails, I'm going to end this video right here. Until next time, stay wilding and thriving. Yes, I did not forget.